Okay, in this video we're going to show you how we can make your own irrigation system. For our main irrigation line, we're going to use this rigid PE pipe. And we're going to use this nut lock fittings, which are both easy and secure. The main irrigation line goes through here, and then you have two exits for the drip lines. We're going to use some drippers, and this is the 6 mm drip line and a water pump. The main irrigation pipe is 16 mm by 1.5 mm. This means that it has 1.5 mm thick walls, and the diameter for the whole pipe is 16 mm. We're going to cut off a piece to use as a main irrigation line. The system we are building is just for a demonstration, so you would of course have a much longer irrigation line, but for demonstration we're going to cut off a small piece. And we are going to position the drip connectors evenly spaced out where you need them to be to easily access your pots. Okay, that's the first one. As you can see, these nut lock fittings, the nut fits the pipe perfectly. So it and it's a small dent in the pipe here, which will be held in place by the bottleneck. We also need to put in an end connector. There might be some noise in the background because of the farmer. But I hope you can hear my voice. On this side we're going to put in an elbow connector, which will go down into the reservoir and connect to the pump. Oh, I almost forgot to put on the mat first. As you can see, this rigid PE pipe doesn't connect well to the pump. The walls are not thick enough. So we'll use this 16 mm flexi pipe. It has the same outer diameter, so it will still fit the nut lock fittings as well as the pump. So the You just need a small piece to go down into the reservoir. Using a small reservoir for demonstration purposes, so you will of course need a longer piece. It's the drip lines. We're just going to use some short drip lines to demonstrate the concept. We're going to cut them with normal scissors. The drip wrists we are using are these adjustable drip stakes. They are adjustable, so you can adjust the amount of water. You can also close them off entirely if you don't need them. About these connectors attached to the drip stakes, these are possible to remove just by wiggling them. We don't need these because we have these nut lock fittings, but as an alternative it's possible to punch a hole through the pipe and push this connector in and connect the drip line like this. We will show you this in another video, but these nut lock fittings are both easier and more secure. This will never leak, but this can leak. If this was in a greenhouse or a real system, we can use these hose clamps to secure the main irrigation line. Like this. To check if the system works, we are just going to use these caps. You would of course use pots, or it could even be outdoors in your garden. And we're going to use this as a reservoir. It's obviously not a reservoir, but that's the same function. Instead of clay pebbles, you might want to use cocoa and perlite mix. This is just for demonstration. Okay, let's see how this goes. As you can see, it's possible to turn down just for a few bits, or you can turn it up and it will. you turn it up, it will cover a pretty big area. Bad demonstration. Like this. To control the watering cycles, you can use a standard mechanical timer like this. It has small pins, four for every hour, so one pin is 50 minutes, and this is just like a clock, so you push down the pins at the times when you want the watering to turn on. So first you turn the wheel to whatever the time is now, and if I want to start watering at 18, push down this pin like this. The wheel will move around with the clock like this, and it reaches the 18 o'clock, which I moved into the down position, it will activate. Activate for 15 minutes and the clock will move on and stop until the next one.